Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to another video on ForgottenWeapons.com. I'm Ian McCollum, and I'm here today at the British Royal Armouries taking a look at an extremely difficult pistol to get a hold of. This is an HK P11, and it is, of course, notable for being HK's super secret underwater pistol. Now, this isn't the first underwater firearm ever developed. It is, however, the most commonly used. This is the one that basically became the NATO standard underwater weapon for frogmen, special operators, and various naval-type units who needed something that could actually shoot underwater. However, it does quite a bit more than that. Now, first off, let's mention that back in the 50s and 60s, there were some other experiments and developments with underwater-capable firearms. And the way most of them chose to work is basically on a pepperbox principle. The idea of having multiple barrels to give you multiple shots instead of having one barrel and cycling ammunition through it. That's because of the problems that being underwater introduces in getting cycling mechanisms to actually work, whether they're recoil or gas or blowback operated. Water just makes that really tricky. It's a lot easier to make a reliable multi-shot underwater pistol or rifle if you just have multiple fixed barrels. So the Russians have an underwater rifle that does, in fact, cycle. Looks vaguely like an AK with a weird magazine. We'll cover that in a future video later. The Russians also have an underwater pistol, which is actually a four-barrel pepperbox style like this. So that's kind of the thing that people adopted. Now, I mentioned that this can do more than just underwater firing, and that's because they made two different types of ammunition for it. One was essentially a four-inch-long dart, that was for firing underwater, minimum drag to maximize your range underwater. The other were essentially traditional looking bullets to be fired above water. And the barrel clusters on these are very easily changed. So you would have a cluster, you could choose a loadout of barrel clusters for underwater use or for above water use. The first patent on the P11 was filed in 1969 by three engineers at HK. Actually, Alex Seidel, one of the founders, was one of them. The gun then went into development through the 1970s, and the first country to adopt it was the German Bundeswehr in 1976. From there, its issuance and sales spread out, and it was used essentially by all of NATO, really. The US used them, some of the Nordic countries used them, I know Norway, Sweden used them, Germany, of course, the UK, France, Italy, basically everybody. You need an underwater pistol, this is your go-to if you're in NATO. So, let's take a closer look at how it works, because it's an underwater pistol that fires electronically, which seems like a really counterintuitive plan. All right, the first thing that you notice when you actually pick one of these things up is that it's actually big. It's a really bulky pistol. It's relatively heavy. This comes in at 2.6 pounds, 1.2 kilograms. And like just the grip is really quite large. Now, we have a couple controls on here. There's a safety. It's just a crossbolt style safety right there. When you see red, that means it's in firing condition. You have this lever in front, and to change the barrel cluster, all you have to do is rotate that forward, and you just pull your cluster of barrels off. So this lug is what locks the barrel cluster into the gun. Now, this one has been fired. This is what a fired barrel cluster typically looks like. This was fired with, I believe, darts. This was an underwater cluster. And so when you fire them, the seals in the front of each barrel are, of course, broken. These cannot be, well, HK doesn't allow any way for these to be reloaded by users. Once you fire a cluster like this, you pack it up and you send it back to HK, and they will reload it for you. The sights are fixed onto the top of the barrel cluster. And then we have five electrical contacts back here. By the way, when the lever is forward, which means that the barrels aren't locked in place, that prevents the safety from being put into the fire position. So I'm gonna put that back, put this on the fire position. And we have actually a relatively nice trigger for a polymer pistol like this. And you hear a click. It's an electronic firing system. So we have contacts here that drop into each of these on the back of the barrel cluster. And then the click is a mechanical actuator that travels from one position to the next. So each time you fire it, the electrical connection rotates to the next barrel in the cluster. So this is a barrel cluster that's been partially disassembled and taped to a return package, which I can't untape it from. But this was one of the clusters of ammunition to be used above water. The round here is a 133 grain bullet fired at about 625 feet per second. So it's not a particularly powerful round, but reasonable for a pistol. Has an effective range, HK says, of about 30 meters. 50 meters is, I think, totally realistic. And the other thing about these is it's that they're silent. So the bullet is housed in a sabot. And if we look straight down the barrel here, you can see that there's a ring when you get partway down. So what happens is both halves are rifled, but you essentially have a large diameter half and then a small diameter half later down. In the large diameter half, the projectile accelerates, and then when it hits that black ring, which is a step down in the bore, the sabot stops, the bullet continues, and the sabot actually seals the chamber. So this is essentially an almost completely quiet firearm. There's also no ejection, there's no mechanical noise other than the click of the trigger. If we flip this around, there's the front end of the barrel, so that's the barrel diameter. They're roughly 30 caliber bullets. So you get five shots that are basically silent, which is great for sneaky people doing sneaky things above water. It's also a very valuable element underwater. So the dart projectiles, and I unfortunately don't have a dart to show you, but the darts are about 4 inches long, pretty small in diameter. They spin hydrodynamically to give them as much accuracy as possible, and they have a similar sealed sabot system. So not only do they not make a lot of noise underwater, which could be a problem for the diver's own ears, the shooter's ears, but it also means that they don't release a big cloud of bubbles, which is valuable if you're trying to be sneaky underwater. So the underwater effective range of the system, of the P11, is about 15 meters, and that's simply because water induces a lot more drag on a projectile than air does. And that apparently is 15 meters where the projectile will still penetrate a compressed air cylinder, which means that's actually quite a lot of power. It would be usable, effective on a human out to a bit longer range, probably not that much longer. Projectiles underwater slow down really quite quickly. If you've seen the footage in, for example, Saving Private Ryan of guys landing at Omaha Beach and bullets hitting the water, and if you were a couple feet underwater, you could essentially catch the bullet safely. That's fairly realistic. One other thing I want to point out here, I said this is electrically fired. Why exactly they did that isn't totally clear to me. But to do that, of course, you need some sort of electrical power. So on the bottom here, we have a battery compartment. The batteries aren't in here, but this used a pair of 12-volt batteries in series. Got a couple electrical connections right there. There is a circuit board to control what, there's not a lot going on in this, but there is a circuit board. It's impregnated in resin to keep it waterproof. The whole system, there's a rubber gasket right on here, and this locks right there, locks the battery into the grip. This is rated as being water resistant down to 10 meters, which is 30 feet, which is frankly not that deep. Certainly you can dive much, much deeper than that safely, even recreationally. So this isn't meant to be, there we go, I'm just gonna leave that loose for the moment. This isn't meant to be taken super deep. You take this down very much deeper, and presumably you run the risk of water infiltrating the electrical connections and causing real problems for the thing.
So there was actually web gear made for the P11. It included a holster and mag pouches for barrel clusters, and apparently, at least for the German issuing of the gun, the standard loadout was one holster and four barrel clusters worth of ammunition. Kind of cool. Like, this is something you could pretty easily reload even underwater. Everything's harder underwater. By the way, I am a certified scuba diver, and I would love to try one of these out underwater. It's not an option for us here at the Royal Armouries, but perhaps someday, if you know of someone who has one of these and wants to try it out on video, let me know. Anyway, these have remained strangely secret in the eyes of the German government. They still consider them secret. I think the patent was only made public, made visible to the public in like 2008. And HK is very tight-lipped about them. So it's very cool that we were able to get a chance to take a close look at this one here at the the Royal Armouries. Like I said, these were issued out to basically all of the military forces in NATO that had an underwater commando organization. I can guarantee you that all of the U.S. Organizations had access to these as well to use. So very cool. One of the most common, most widely used of a very specialized sort of firearm. So obviously a really big thanks to the Royal Armouries for giving me access to this. I would also like to give a big thanks to my friend Andy at HK for encouraging me to make this video happen. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for watching.